हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग ऑन नेफ्रोटिक सिंड्रोम विथ इट्स आयुर्वेदिक कोरिलेशन। नेफ्रोटिक सिंड्रोम इज इंक्रीज परमिएबिलिटी ऑफ ग्लोमेरुलस लीडिंग टू लॉस ऑफ प्रोटीन इनटू द ट्यूब्यूल्स एंड इट इज कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय मैसिव प्रोटीनूरिया विच इज मोर देन 3 ग्राम इन 24 आवर ऑफ यूरिन सैंपल, हाइपोएल्बुमिनिया दैट इज less than 25 gram per liter, edema and hypercholesterolemia, dyslipidemia. Sign and symptom: new onset of edema which is initially periorbital or peripheral, later genitals, ascites and anasarca is find, frothy urine, generalized symptoms, lethargy, fatigue, reduced appetite, etc. are signs and symptoms of nephrotic syndrome. Causes of nephrotic syndrome: primary glomerulonephritis. Primary glomerulonephritis is where there is not a specific cause of nephrotic syndrome is found. So it is termed as primary glomerulonephritis. Minimal changes disease, which is account for 80% of pediatric cases. Why this name is given minimal changes disease? Because there is very minimal changes in glomerulus which can not be seen by normal microscope and can be only visible by powerful microscope. Focal segmental glomerulosclerosis, most common case in adults, and membranous glomerulonephritis. So these are some primary glomerulonephritis. Systemic causes, that is secondary glomerulonephritis, which can be diabetic nephropathy, sarcoidosis, autoimmune SLE Sjögren syndrome, infection that can be cause syphilis, hepatitis B, HIV, amyloidosis. Investigation: urine dipstick can be done, urine microscopic, blood examination, renal ultrasound, renal biopsy for all adults can be done. Children generally trial of steroid first. In case of children, we generally prefer prescription of steroids. Management: conservative management is salt and fluid restriction, medical management, diuretics, ACE inhibitors, corticosteroid, immunosuppression, surgical is renal transplant. So these are some management. When we see in part of Ayurveda, this feature can be correlated with Sandrameh. Sandrameh of subtype of Prameh. There is no exact correlation of nephrotic syndrome in Ayurveda, but we can say this is a type of Prameh Sandrameh. According to Ayurveda, Kapha Vata dominating three dosha is involved, as well as Rasa, Mutra, Udak, Oj are some component which get involved in this disease. Nephrotic syndrome, if we see pathology of this disease, we get that there is damage of glomerulus. To find out Ayurvedic answer of why damage is occurring, here we see Basti is a specific case of Vata. Symptom are producing looking like Prameh and Mutra coming from protein, giving us dominance of Kapha. So we see there is Vata, Pitta and Kapha. There is involvement of three dosha. Why damage of glomerulus is occurring? Due to enzyme digesting cells of glomerulus. So Pitta is responsible, as Pitta is responsible for all metabolism and enzymatic activity. Pitta is brought by vitiated Vata from its normal place or increases Pitta concentration on that place. So there is involvement of three dosha, Vata, Pitta and Kapha. Line of treatment should be done in Ayurveda: Pitta normalization, Matra Basti to be given to balance Vata. There is protein loss, so clade Kapha is losing from body. To provide proper clade, give adequate protein diet. Medicine in Prameh Chikitsa, which is described by our ancient Acharya, should be done in Apanavat Kal, as there is Vikriti of Apanavat, Agni of patient should be normalized. So this can be some possible line of treatment in nephrotic syndrome. Discuss later about Ayurvedic approach separately, and we will made a separate video for this nephrotic syndrome. Thank you very much for watching this.